Well, 1 week from today, Pope Benedict XVI will arrive for his first visit to the U.S.
And as we prepare for that historic event, it brings back a lot of memories of the late Pope, especially when Pope John Paul II came right here to Baltimore. I recently sat down with Cardinal Keeler for a look back.
Is the anchor man for television.
I had the honor of attending an audience with Pope John Paul II a few years before his visit to Baltimore. Cardinal William Keeler had just been installed as Baltimore's Archbishop, and he personally introduced a small group of us to the Pontiff.
Holy Father, this is Rod Daniels.
Very important man. I remember myself what I said.
You said that he is our newscaster, and he is also Catholic. Ah, a bridge. TV and the church.
Pope John Paul II traveled that bridge himself when he came to the U.S. in 1995 and celebrated a Mass televised live from Camden Yards.
You know, he changed that stadium into an outdoor cathedral just with the sign of the cross.
It was the result of years of work Cardinal Keeler is largely credited with organizing. He was the president of the Bishops' Conference at the time, and Washington's Apostolic Nuncio asked him what he thought of plans for a U.S. visit by the Pope. Naturally, he thought it was a wonderful idea, and he slipped in a good word for his hometown.
I learned later that the word did get through to him, and that each time that the people would come to brief him on how the arrangements were working out, he would say, "How about Baltimore?"
After all, Baltimore is essentially the birthplace of Catholicism in the United States.
And as I recall, our trip to Rome, the Holy Father was very, very sharp on the importance of Baltimore to Catholicism in the United States.
That's right. He was. He learned the lesson. We have the first cathedral here, the first of everything that happened in the Catholic Church.
But it wasn't just an occasion for Catholics to enjoy.
One of the things that I learned just a couple of days beforehand was that I could invite up to seven people to greet the Pope and at the airport. And one of them happened to be Jewish, Willard Hackerman. And Willard and I were talking beforehand. He said, "Is it all right if I say a prayer in Hebrew for the Pope?" I said, "Willard, the Pope needs everybody's prayers, so that's quite all right."